What is going on, YouTube? SciGuy29 coming at you for another episode of Crafts and Cards. That means it's Tuesday. We're in February, and that means one thing. Okay, that means two things. Okay, more than two things, but Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day. A little early to all, but in case I forget to say it next week. But spring training starts in a few days, weeks. It's getting exciting. With the World Baseball Classic, things are pushed up a little bit. Excited about all that. Good beer tonight. The reason I can say that is this is take two of this episode. So, had a little slight mishap on the first attempt. But hope all is well. Haven't said that. Sorry about that. Welcome to the beautiful Cardboard Pub, where tonight I'm going to drink a Goose Island Christmas Ale. And this is a 38 IBU, or International Bitter Units, and 7.5 ABV. And it is an IPA. It's their Christmas release. Goose Island has produced Christmas beers a lot over the years. And you're going to see that this is not going to pour anywhere near a full glass like it typically does. And for the life of me, I can't remember who asked me to do a Goose Island beer. I think I've done the Goose Island IPA in the past. They've got great beers. It's one of the first, it's kind of one of the breweries that got me into craft beer, honestly. They have a beer called Honker's Ale that when I first started drinking craft beer, I could get it here in town, and I drank the shit out of it. It's good stuff. I had it when I went to Wrigley, the one and only time I've been to Wrigley. But looking forward, hopefully sometime this year at the National, maybe, to getting to Goose Island Brewery down in Wrigleyville and see what happens. But a little light test for you, a little darker for an IPA, the Christmas aspect. And I'm not really sure, they didn't really say much about it other than it's a festively smooth IPA. So we'll put that back there. Cheers. Good stuff. The cards. Not a very big stack tonight. And a little something different. We're going to go through all four major sports. With some vintage cards. Some more vintage than others. Sort of like the one I'm going to start with. This is a 1958 Moose Scourin. I love the fact they actually put Moose on there. They have Bill on the back. But it does say Moose on the front. And that is needed for my 58 set. So that's awesome. Here we have a 78 Fred Lynn. Just was reading something online not too many weeks ago. A couple weeks ago, probably. And this person, I don't remember who it was, but wrote an article saying that if he would have stayed in Boston, that he'd be a Hall of Famer right now. Don't know if that's true or not, but could certainly probably make a case for it because his best years certainly were there. And it was just an interesting article, how they laid out why they thought that. But here we have a 60s Mike McCormick. This card has a little bit more meaning to me than a lot of others, just not because of the card. It's not an expensive card or anything like that. But there was a guy when I was growing up in my hometown whose dad helped run the grocery store. So he always had access to more cards because his dad would order from the people that were coming into the store that would carry him. And he had a gazillion. And this is one I made a trade with him for. I got this and a 61 Roger Maris for a tall boy Kareem Abdul, like a 70, what is it, 78, 70, 76? 76, Kareem Abdul-Jabbar, I think is what it was. So I remember it was something from that set. So I was really excited. Just a card with a little more meaning than usual. I'm going to jump to some football. We have this beautiful, is that 74, 75, 75, I was 74, 74, 75, Alan Page for the Vikings collection. This isn't in too bad a shape, really. Little indentation toward his shoulder pad there. From that same set, we have the 74 Champs card. Chuck Foreman, my guy there, going up and over against the Rams. They would again lose that Super Bowl, as they have every other one. Here's that guy, Chuck Foreman. Love the 1,000-yard rusher football up there. Wish they would have put it on the other side so it wasn't covering up his head. But, hey, what are you going to do? One of the greatest running backs, not in the Hall of Fame, I would think. Had some great, great years. Great pass catcher out of the backfield. I think he even led the NFL once or twice in receptions. Fran thanked him. Here we have a 73, Roy Winston, linebacker for the Vikes. Here we have a, 81, I believe, Vern Denherter. For those of you who don't know anything about Vern Denherter, he's an Iowa guy up from Sioux Center area by the northwest part of the state, and played at Central College, which is a Division III school in Pella. A perennial Division III football power. Have backed up a little bit, but they're still really good here in the middle part of the country. But he had a 10-plus year NFL career. Now he's still alive, owns a giant cattle operation up in northwest Iowa. Here we have this beautiful 60s Fran Tarkington with the New York Giants there. And I really don't know what this set is. You see the giant crease there. Fran had a big nose before, but the crease goes right through his nose. Here we have an Alan Ameche. Not sure of the year on this either, but I've had this a long time. I remember getting at a show down in Des Moines when I was probably in middle school. I always tried to buy one vintage baseball and one vintage football card at every show I went to. Now these next four are for a set that I'm about two-thirds of the way done with, and that is the 78-79 Tops. Here's the Dr. J that I needed. And all of the cards that I had, I think I probably had 100 cards, and out of those I think I had 68 or 70 non-duplicates. That I remember buying when I went to my grandparents for Christmas that year. So that was not one of them. Here we have a John Gianelli with the Bucks. Bob Gross with the Blazers. If I'm not mistaken, I think they won the NBA title that year. And here we have Sven Nader of the Buffalo. I've got double. Sven Nader of the Buffalo Braves, and Lionel Hollins of the Blazers as well. So nice. I forgot I had two of those. Here we have another Buffalo Brave, and this is a 77-78 Adrian Dantley. And I just noticed today on this and the next card that if you look at the copyright, it still has the 69 agreement with the Players Association and the NBA properties. So it's that way on that card, as well as this 74-75 card commemorating the years before finals. And the last but not least, I've got five hockey cards. And these are 72-73 Tops. We're going to start with Mr. Marcel Dion. These are in good shape. I bought these down in the last show I went to in August. So here we have Jacques Plante. Love the old goalie pads. Ed Jacquemin with the Rangers. Mr. Tony Esposito, the Blackhawks. And last, but certainly not least, with the Red Wings, Mr. Alex Delvecchio. So a few vintage from all four major sports. Hope all is well. And like the sign says, collect what you love. Love what you collect. Till next time. Cheers.